So we have here the new Lorex 2K Quad HD quality battery-powered Wi-Fi security cameras. Is this a good option for your home? Let's find out. Hello guys, Lifehackster here. Today we are going to check out, finally, a Lorex brand camera. Not their PoE NVR cameras yet, but their battery-powered Wi-Fi security camera system. Lorex didn't even send this to me, but Adorama did, and I have to give them a shout out on this video. Thank you, Adorama, for sending this out to me for a review. If you are a content creator, videographer, or photographer, you definitely know Adorama. I bought camera gear from them for this channel, and now they have expanded to carry smart home and security cameras. And this is going to be a great partnership not only for them, but also for my channel. Because now I can also check and test out brands that I don't normally review, like this Lorex, which I know a lot of you have been asking me to check out, especially their NVR system. And that one is in the works. Anyways, Lorex has this 2K or Quad HD battery-powered Wi-Fi camera that we are going to check out. We will do the unboxing, check out its features, check its video and audio quality, and run the usual tests, and see if this Lorex Wi-Fi camera will be a good fit for your home security camera needs. Let's check out its features. So this is a camera system with a base station and records up to 2K quality with a 4 megapixel image sensor, which is twice the resolution of 1080p. This kit comes with two cameras and has a 140 degree field of view. It records to the base station and comes with a 32GB card, and you can install up to a 256GB card. It has color night vision if you have some ambient lighting, which you will check out later on. It has built-in person detection, which is good to avoid unwanted alerts and recordings. It has smart deterrence with a motion-activated LED warning light, and it also has a siren and has two-way talk. The hub can act as a chime to alert you when motion has been detected, and no monthly subscription fees with local microSD card recording, and you can connect up to 6 cameras to one hub. It has smart integration with Amazon Alexa and Google Home. For specific specs, the camera records 2560 by 1440 resolution at 15 frames per second. Full duplex two-way audio. It can connect to both 2.4 and 5 GHz Wi-Fi. Battery life of 3 to 6 months, but really depends on your use. The cameras are weather resistant, IP65 rated with an operating temperature of -4 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's open up the box. We have a quick start guide, mounting templates, window decals, then we have two wall mounts. Then we have the camera themselves. So we have a small LED light here on top. We have the camera lens, mic and light sensor, and PIR motion detector here in the middle, and the speaker in the bottom front. We have a rubber pad here in the bottom if you're installing it in a shelf. On top, we have the Lorex branding, and on the back, we have the quarter 20 thread. Which I can tell you that design-wise, unless they make a specialized mount, it cannot be installed in a ceiling or horizontal install. But I guess you can make it to work installing it inverted. And we have the microSD port to charge or continually power the camera, and probably future solar panel port. You can turn the bottom part counterclockwise to unlock and open up the battery compartment. And this is where you're going to insert the rechargeable battery pack. And we also have the sync button switch here. This kit comes with two cameras, and this is the second one. What else is inside the box? We have the power adapter, 2 amps and 5 volts. And we have the micro USB cable, one power adapter and cable to charge the batteries, and one to power up the Lorex home hub. Then we have the battery pack that looks almost the same as Ring's. This is a 6250 mAh battery, and it also has a micro USB port to charge it. Lorex states that the battery life is around 3 to 6 months, but it will really depend on the number of activations, the length of the recording, and also on cold temperatures. Then we have some mounting screws and plastic anchors. We have the Ethernet cable to hook up the hub to your router if you want to. It can also connect wirelessly via Wi-Fi. And then we have the Lorex home hub, and we have the status light here in the front, and we have the speaker holes. And on the back, we have an Ethernet port to connect this to your router. I will use wireless Wi-Fi connection on the setup later on. We have the micro USB port to power up the hub, We have the SYNC bun and a micro SD card slot with a 32GB card included. And this is where the recordings will be stored. Now time to set this up. Download, sign up, and log into the Lorex Home app. Click the plus sign to add your device, which we will add the hub first. Scan the QR code which is on the bottom of the Home Hub. Click Next. And now you choose which connection you want, and I'll choose Wi-Fi here just because I have a mesh network. But you can also choose wired connection, which you need to connect the hub to your router with the use of the included Ethernet cable. I'll choose wireless in this setup. Now type in a device password, choose your Wi-Fi network, and wait until the hub is added to your account. Name the hub, which I'll name mine Lorex Hub. Time to pair the cameras. Slide the battery pack on the camera. Push the sync button on the hub. Then press the sync or reset button on the camera until it flashes green and sounds a chime. Then click Next. Wait until the camera is connected to the hub, and it will show the live view and Wi-Fi signal strength, which is good. Time to check out the settings in the app. On the main app page, you will see the cameras connected to the hub, and to see the other cameras, you have to swipe to the left. Clicking on the thumbnail will start the live view, which has some delay. And in here, you can pause the live view. You can change the viewing resolution to SD or HD. You can unmute the speaker, and you can expand the live view. You can also take a snapshot of the current view, which will be saved in the app. You can start two-way talk. You can also record the current view, and this will also be saved in the app. In here, you can activate the siren, which you can only activate manually and not when it detects motion. You can turn on and off the LED light, and this one you can set up to turn on when it detects motion. Then the privacy mode to turn off the notifications and recordings. On the upper right corner, we can go to the camera settings, which we have the notifications where you can schedule them or choose if you want a thumbnail preview. Please note that it can cause some delay in notification. We have motion detection settings, turn on or off motion, and person detection. And person detection sensitivity can be adjusted from low, medium, or high. And motion sensitivity from 1 to 6, and 6 is the highest sensitivity. Then we have light settings, the LED light on or off, and you can pick from flashing or solid light. Then we have motion zones. So you can check all boxes in the grid and just erase the area you don't want to monitor. Please note that the detection of the camera is dependent on where the motion is. So even if you include a zone that is in the view but more than 20 or 25 feet, the camera will not be able to detect it. Then we have sound settings. You can adjust the volume of the siren and the two-way talk. Auto night vision, on or off. Privacy mode again if you want the camera to be off. We have the performance mode. And we have the power saver, which the camera will only record 720p and a minute cool-off. We have performance optimization, which will record in full HD 1080p. Higher performance, which the camera records in 2K quality, but it will also drain your battery quicker. Or a custom mode where you can adjust the video quality from 720p and up to 2K. And recording duration from 10 seconds to a minute. Interval duration, which is the cool-off, from 0 seconds to 60 seconds. Now I can tell you that this setting doesn't work. The footage still stops when the camera senses that there is no more motion. Which on this camera, it happens pretty quick. If I just pause and stop in front of the camera for a bit, it will stop the recording. And this will be one of the issues in this camera, which I'll talk more later on. We have battery status, audio recording and status LED on or off. And if you're able to install the camera in a ceiling, which most likely you need to install the camera upside down, then you can flip the image. Back to the main app page, in the bottom, there is the events icon, which you will see all the recorded footages on the microSD card. Click on it to play the footage. And I realize in here that there is no option to download or export the footage to your phone. And the only way to do this is to click on the video camera icon, which then the footage will be saved in the app's video and photo folder. And this is where you can download it to your phone. You can also go and see the settings of the hub by clicking the three dots on top. And this is where we have the sound settings to turn on and off the motion chime when it detects motion and change the chime volume. Device storage, and this is the status of the microSD card. Time to do some testing, but before that, if you like this video, Matter Videos, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. and click the bell notification so as to get notified when I upload product reviews like this video, product updates, comparison videos, and long-term reviews. Thank you. Before I'll show you the testing, I'll tell you first, and I said earlier that a custom mode to set a set time for the camera to record doesn't work. And also, as you will see later on, the motion maximum detection distance is only around 15 to 20 feet. So if I also get out of this zone, then the camera will also stop recording. So you will see me running back and forth just to keep the camera to record and not stop.
So this is the video and audio quality of the Lorex 2K Quad HD wireless Wi-Fi camera. And its maximum detection distance is only 15 feet. So I need to be in this range before it turns soft. Anyways, this is the video clarity test at 10 feet. 15, so I'm gonna trigger it again. Just making sure. 20, 25, let's trigger it again. 30. Running math test. 40. So this is the video quality of the Lorex 2K battery powered wireless Wi-Fi camera at night, and lights on, and also its little spotlight is also turned on, and this is what it looks like at 10 feet and it turned off. And this is at 15 feet, 20, 25, 30. So this is the video quality of the Lorex 2K wireless battery powered Wi-Fi camera. And I'm moving around because if I stopped and stayed put, the recording will turn off. So it's not just turned off right now, but it's still recording. As long as I move around. So this is at 10 feet, 15, 20, 25.
So we are going to test the motion alert notification speed of the Lorex 2K wireless Wi-Fi camera. And I'm on my LTE connection and it is 1048. So let's check it out. There you go, the little spotlight turned on there. And we'll just wait for the notification. I got the notification, and when you click and hold, you'll get a snapshot preview. And when you click on it, it will get you right there. Cool. Okay, so we are going to test the cool off or the cool down period of the Lorex 2K wireless Wi-Fi camera, and it's 1049, so it's been about a minute. And I've set this the performance wise so that it'll be little to no cool off. So let's check it out. There you go, got detected again with that little spotlight turning on, and there's a little bit of delay in notification, but yeah, I got the notification. So now we are going to test the maximum detection distance of this Lorex 2K wireless Wi-Fi camera. And I've set everything to high, the person detection sensitivity to high, the motion sensitivity to the highest. And I don't get any false notifications on this. And the motion zones is the whole area. So let's check it out. Okay, at 30 feet. And I will see if that little spotlight will turn on, which it didn't detect me at 30 feet. Let's go 25. Didn't detect me at 25. And let's go at 20 feet. I didn't get detected at 20 feet. Let's go 15. There you go. Got the spotlight on, and we'll get a notification here. All right. Well, got detected at only 15 feet. And let's go 20. See, one got triggered at 20. You just heard that notification. And let's go 15. Now the other one didn't even trigger at 15 feet. There you go. It has a little bit delay. I got the notification too. All right, so I guess it's safe to say a detection distance on both cameras, they will be reliable at 15 feet. Not really reliable at 20 feet, but they can detect up to 20 feet. That's with the maximum sensitivity and maximum person detection sensitivity on both of them.
This is the audio quality coming out from the Lorex 2K wireless Wi-Fi camera.
So what do you think, guys? Video quality is okay, but it has the same type of compression that Eufy uses on their Eufy Cam 2 and 2 Pro. At 30 feet, you will see the distortion, and you cannot make out my face. I'll be comparing this camera to the Eufy Cam 2 Pro soon, and see which one has better video quality. The issue about recording length and the custom recording time setting should be fixed by Lorex, and they need to update the camera so that it will continue to record a little bit longer when it detects motion. This can be fixed by a firmware update. As to the PIR sensor sensitivity, I'm not sure if this is a hardware issue, but its reliable detection distance is only about 15 to 20 feet, and not able to detect 25 feet and beyond like other cameras. I hope this can be fixed also. Aside from that, in my setup, in my backyard, it detects every person passing by its detection range, and has no false detection yet. Any questions? Comment down below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.